What we all need to be doing, pray, pray, pray.
And stay positive.
That's right. Hey, that's good together.
It does. You know, I was trying to think what we could talk about this morning. The verse that came to my mind was 1 Peter 5, verse 7, casting all your care upon him, for he careth for you. Verse 5 says, likewise, ye younger, submit yourselves unto the elder. Yeah, all of you, be subject one to another, and be clothed with humility, for God resisteth the proud and give grace to the humble. Humble yourselves, therefore, under the mighty hand of God, that he may exalt you in due time, casting all your care upon him, for he careth for you. Be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about, seeking whom he may devour. Thinking about this first, I was kind of thinking, you know, how do we cast our cares upon, you know, the Lord?
One thing, you know, you pray.
Yeah.
Pray.
That's one of the main things, yeah.
And pray, trust.
And trust him and read his word. As I was thinking on this verse, and I knew we wanted to do a devotional about it, you know, I was thinking, well, what are some burdens that you can bring to him and cast on him that you're carrying around? Think, you know what your burdens are. We know what our burdens are. What are your worries? What are you worrying about? I tend to worry over little things, and that's something that I have asked the Lord to help me with. We're supposed to trust God, and you know, and like it says, cast our cares, cast our worries, cast our burdens upon him. And the hardest part of all that is letting it go, like we have talked before. Pray about it. Leave it to him. Leave it at his feet. Leave it in his hands.
And trust.
And trust him. But that is so hard for us to do. It is for me.
She can tell you. I used to worry myself crazy over my children. Mm-hmm. But I prayed and prayed and asked God to take some of this worriness away from me, where I had to talk to him 3 times a day. Mm-hmm. I mean, it was crazy. And you know, and he has. But do I worry about some things that go on? Yes.
Are we going to? Yes. Because we're human.
But I'm not worried
every
day.
You don't let it consume your life now like it did.
And it used to.
Well,
it used to, yes.
It really did. And
thank God for that.
You know, Earl used to worry, you know, in his younger years, like Tina, he prayed and asked the Lord to take that away from him. And God delivered him from that. Mm-hmm. I will have to say, he don't worry about a thing. He don't.
Sometimes she's like, I wish he would worry about a little something.
I know. And so, but no, I'm glad he don't, because I do, and it's not a good place to be. Cast your anxieties on him. I deal with anxiety a lot. I have for a few years, and you know, it's almost like it just dropped out of the sky one day. And it's held on for a long time. And I don't know where it came from. I don't know why I deal with that. And I don't like to talk about it a lot to people, because if you don't have it, if you don't struggle with it,
you don't understand it.
You know, some people would say, you know, well, just, you know, do this, do that. But it's not that easy. But that is one thing I am praying about. And Tina has been praying about. She told me the other day, I think she's got it on her prayer closet.
I got my little notes up on the wall.
In her prayer closet. We said worries, we said anxieties, grief. I'm sure everyone's lost someone that's really close to them. Grief is a big thing for me. And I have been praying the Lord to lift that. Because sometimes, and it has. I mean, I'm a lot better than I was. But of course, like everybody, has days where it's constantly on your mind, you know. And yesterday was a day for me. And a Friday, I believe, I just got my mama on my mind. You know, it was on my mind all day. And then I had to you know, ask God to help me. And so I could go, I don't know how to explain it. If I was to let it, it would consume me. Yeah. It really would. I think it would really consume me. But we need to cast our grief on him. And like I've been trying to do, I'm not saying I want to forget my mom and my dad and those that I've lost. No, that is not what I'm saying at all. But, you know, I'm not where I was.
Mm-hmm.
I am better. Mm-hmm. But I don't know. I don't want to go into all that because I'll get to crying. But ask him to help us to deal with it in a godly way, in the way he wants us to grieve, and not let it consume us. Well, if you struggle with guilt, something maybe you've done in your past, and it just eats at you or whatever, you know, ask the Lord to take that guilt feeling away.
Because God's forgotten about it. Jesus has forgotten it.
If you have asked, you know, Jesus to forgive you your sins, come live in your heart, you know, and all of that, then he don't remember that. That's gone. Mm-hmm. It's gone. I know it's hard to forgive yourself of things. I know that.
You know, I know someone that always felt guilty and always about their past, the way they lived their life in the past. Well, it's like I told them, you know, Jesus has forgave you from all of that.
Yeah.
He's through all that in the sea of forgetfulness.
Mm-hmm. My daddy had lung cancer. Mama had heart and kidney issues. And when we were going through all of that, it was hard. It was hard to pray. I mean, we did it. You know, I prayed, you know, that the Lord would heal her. That wasn't what he chose to do. But, you know, I tried to cast all that on the Lord and not worry about it so much. Let him take care of it. And, I mean, when you're going through all these things, it's hard. I mean, what we're saying is easier said than done. You know, we should put all our trust in the Lord. We should cast all of our burdens upon him because he can carry them.
He can carry them
better than we can. He knows better than we do. He knows what's best for our lives. He will answer you. Like I've said before, it may not be when you wanted it or when you felt like you needed it or how you wanted it answered. But like I said, he knows all. He knows what's best for us.
And he's when the best time to answer that.
Yeah. Y'all know that song, He's an On-Time God? He's an on-time God. Yes, he is. Whoa, on-time God.
Yes, he is.
Job said he may not come when you want him, but he'll be there right on time. Yeah, he's an on-time God.
Yes, he is. I haven't heard anybody sing
that in a long time.
Me too.
He's an on-time God. He might not be on your time, but he's on time. But just have to remember that, y'all. Telling myself that too. Place your burdens on him. You cast your cares on him. Whatever it is. And he's there for you. He loves you. Like I've said. Well, I don't know if I said it and y'all heard it. I think I said it on the other devotion. He's not out to get you. He's not out to hurt you. He loves you. Yeah. He wants what's best for you at that time in your life. So, you know, ask him for help. Hey, Lord, I need you. You know, talk to him like we're talking to each other. Lord, I need you. You know, I got this, that, and the third going on. Like when Mama was sick and they had called and said, you know, we're going to let her come home if everything stays good, you know, da, da, da. And the very next hour or two, she went unresponsive. And I went, you know, all to pieces. I went into my closet over here in my spare bedroom. And I got in there and I shut the door. I pleaded with God. I pleaded with him. I poured my heart out to him. You know, I cannot lose my mama. I've got to have her. And I went through all of that. But it just wasn't God's will. It wasn't God's will for her to make it through. Why, I still don't know. He knows. And that's one thing I had a hard time dealing with is why, God, why did you take my mama? You know, I mean, it's just, that's been something hard for me. And I'm sure that has been hard for some of y'all, you know, with different things and things we just don't understand. I don't understand. I'm not here to help you understand because I don't understand it. I don't understand it. Just like Earl told me before I rededicated my life back in February, I was having a very, very hard time, you know, with losing mama. I mean, there were days, I mean, several days in a row, all I done was cry and I would get angry. And I had all kind of feeling you think you could have. I had them all. And sometimes I have them sometimes, you know, but they're not as
frequent.
But I was saying, I'm just ready to see my mom. I want to see my mom. I want to see my daddy. And I just went through all that. And he looked at me and Earl is the type of person, he's going to tell you what, you know, you might not want to hear.
What he thinks and what's right. Mm-hmm. If you like it or not.
And he told me, he said, well, honey, he said, if you want to see them again, you've got to get your heart right with the Lord. If you want to see them again. And that stuck with me. And I didn't do it for a good while. Are you crying? I didn't do it for a good while. Because I wasn't ready. I had too much anger in me because of losing Mama. But February 28th, I rededicated my life. You know, right here, sitting on my couch, folding clothes, watching the service from our church on Facebook. And I did. And God has helped me. He has helped me so much that I really don't have that resentment or that anger or that bitterness. Now, that's not to say that grief doesn't creep up and then I'm miserable because I am. Like I said, I had that Saturday. I had some of it Saturday and then Friday. I mean, it's one thing that brought it up. You know, like I said in one of the videos, I'm moving files and stuff from my computer to that tower. Well, like I've got thousands and thousands and thousands of photos and videos of my mama and my daddy, even up until they were gone. I mean, while they were sick and everything, because I don't want to forget nothing. If you show me a picture of my daddy, I can tell you what we were doing, what was happening right then. I can do the same thing with mama.
I wish I could.
And I don't want to forget those times. And so that's what started it. I was watching her last birthday party yard. I had them come out and put out the card that says happy 80th birthday, Mama. And I saw those pictures, those videos, and that just threw me in it. But you know, I prayed and read the word, and you know, I'm doing okay. But I don't know. We just got off on all kinds of stuff. But anyway, getting back to our little devotion. But maybe that'll help somebody, like I always said. Maybe it'll help somebody. And like before we did this devotional, I prayed for Tina to come over here that the Lord would use us in whatever way he sees fit. And that we, you know, do this to the best of our ability, the way we understand it and the way we feel like God has intended it for us to understand. Because like we said before, we don't want to mislead nobody. And I'm just going to look at it. This is the way the Lord had it planned out to go. I don't know what you're going through. Right. You may have lost somebody close to you.
And you might have needed to hear
it. You may need to hear it. Whatever we're talking about is something that's going to resonate with you and stick with you and touch you and let you know you're not alone. You know, you hear that.
Right.
You're not alone. People told me that before.
Right.
And at the time you're going through anything, you feel alone. Mm-hmm. You do. And at times I still feel alone. I do. I mean, I know people have lost their mamas and their daddies, people close to them, children. I know that. But when you're going through it and it's you, it's different. Yeah. It really is different. And I never really knew that. I knew it, but I didn't know it until I lost my daddy. You know, I lost a big part of me. I lost my mom and my daddy, the ones that gave life to me. You know, and it's, you know, my dad used to tell me all the time growing up, you need to learn how to do this because I'm not going to be here all the time. Well, I didn't pay it no mind because I'm thinking they're going to live forever. Try your best to, you know, to cast it upon the Lord because he cares for you. He does. And he loves us. And he wants what's best for us. And he's not going to hurt us, that's for sure. Hope you enjoyed our little devotional today. I really do, really, really do hope it
touches somebody.
Touches you know.
Somebody.
If you just happen to run across this, I really hope it does touch your heart. And I hope it does let you know that even though we're not hearing it, you're not alone. You're really not.
No.
And like we've said before, if you have a prayer request or anything you're praying about, you can leave it in the comments below. You don't have to be specific. So not unless you want to. Just know, you know, that whoever sees our comments will see that. I mean, you know, it's public. But we will write it down. We'll put it in our little prayer jar, and we'll be praying for y'all. I think we're going to go get us some lunch. It's 11 o'clock.
Been wanting me a chicken cheese biscuit from a Bojangles and dirty rice, and I'm excited about that.
So we're going to get out what I'm going to get. We're going to bring y'all with us. Show everybody your pretty face. Look at that pretty boy. Look at that pretty boy.
They're dressing up at work today, so I don't tomorrow. They're dressing up to work tomorrow. I don't work tomorrow, so I decided to put on my little Halloween shirt. Mama bought me this a few years back, and Annette has on the little
hat. She asked me if I want to wear the hat just for the video, but we have a short up, her coming in dressed like this, and I thought it was so cute. She had this. She's going to wear this on her head.
There's Tina, y'all. There's Ollie. We're at the vet. We're taking Ollie to the vet. There he is again. Hey, Ollie.
Hey, Ollie.
He's not happy, y'all. He don't like to come to the doctor.
Bless
his heart. Howled all the way here. Howled. I mean howled, not bored. Howled. I hate going in with all these other dogs in here. There's a big one in there.
Oh, it was there. Well, we can wait. It's,
you know how
early.
He acts. Barking and acting all crazy.
Well, I mean, it's early. We can sit in the Jeep and listen to Neil if you want to.
Well, let's do that.
Okay.
Let's see
if he's got a fever.
A fever?
He.
Oh,
he's gonna get.
We're going to the vet this morning.
Yes, we are.
We're going to get them ears looked at.
I believe it's got an ear infection. I think it's got some skin allergies.
Yeah, bless his old
heart.
So we're
going to see about that. Them
it's
two
okay,
things.
Buddy. Don't be scared. Or just don't talk about it no more and make him scared.
So we got the more he the louder he howled. I don't mean bark. I mean ah.
Checked in. Hey, buddy, it's okay.
Y'all, I have been trying to get in change out. I had a whole,
Can I have something to leave this up? We come to get some coffee.
Yeah, I had a whole pocket book of change, and I was giving her, because she has a little thing. She calls it her coffee fund. And so I give her my change sometimes. So I had a whole slew of change. Everything back in my pocketbook.
That's my coffee fund, y'all.
Trying to get everything in it. Now, where's my sunshades at? Where they at?
They're on your neck. She's so dumb. Sorry, but she's crazy. Y'all.
There they are.
What I want her to do, and I've been trying to tell her for the last, how long we've been sitting in this parking lot, is I want you to get on your phone.
Oh.
And I want you to go.
See?
I want you to go to Starbucks app and see how much your coffee was last time. So then we can get out of here. It's $2.84. You got the, wait a minute, what's a Milana Soul? What is that? A splash of cream, half and half, 4 packs of sugar. Remember the other day, y'all, she put 14 sugars in there.
So I got enough to get my coffee. I might.
$2.84.
So I need, is that a medium?
That's a tall, that's a small.
Okay, that's
you
fine.
Want
small, that's
you
all
want
I need. That's all
well,
I
need. Well, just say $3.
Do I need to be on my scan?
Yes.
Scan is $1.
You got $2.
What's that telling me?
We got $3. You might get a grande.
I don't want one. I just want a small.
You got to go to scan only.
Okay.
And that's what you're going to scan. Here's $3. So that can get your coffee.
See?
So after we
and she's still got a little change left because she's about it.
Listen. Mm-hmm. What we're doing today is, time to get into show, honey.
Get into movie theater.
She always looks like she don't have anything but just that.
All I show is my neck and head.
I'm going to try to hold it. But we're coming to get us a coffee. It's 9:30. You know, went to the vet. That was very quick. Did you realize how quick that was?
Well, it was. It was
her
quick.
Her appointment
was 8:30.
Her appointment was at 8:30. We went in at
8:20.
We would call back there. We were leaving at 8.
45, 50?
No, it wasn't that late.
I was home at 9:00.
Yeah.
So that tells you how fast that appointment
was. It
was
quick. I've we never had it that quick before. But
and she lives there. You live at the vet.
That's why I feel the same. My mess is always more in depth with my youngins.
Had an ear infection. Well, they went ahead and done his ears. Packed his ears. And also, because he's gnawing at his feet with allergies. And so they went ahead and gave him a shot of steroids and gave me some medicine that I had to give him twice, half of one every 12 hours. And so anyway, I just want to let you know that's what the vet does since we said we went to the vet. I'll tell you what the diagnosis was. It's the infection and allergy.
And the vet's expensive, y'all. Y'all been to the vet
lying.
Lately?
I want to fall out right there on the floor and just fall out and just lay
she
just
did.
Like
I had
this.
To, I had to hold her together. I say, listen now. We were walking around the corner. I said, now she gave him a shot. I was like, good, that going to set you back a minute.
The shot won't as much as the
it
medicine.
It won't. The medicine was more. But I mean, if he has to stay on that, that's what it would be.
That's going
to
be high.
Think about Bella. She was on, at one time, 4 different medications. And they were not cheap. But
bless her heart.
You know, we love our children. I mean, love our animals.
Yeah.
You know, you got to take care of them. I want to go to that little place. That meat market. What was the name of it? The organic meat marketplace. We went Monday, but it was closed. I don't want to get some of that chocolate milk if they have it in the glass bottle. I honestly, I'm really buying it for the glass bottle. But you can take the glass bottle back and get a $3 thing, deposit thing back.
And I said, she spoke about milk. I was going to tell you, Anthony then went to the store yesterday after he got off of work, and or day before. And
Didn't he have any?
What?
Oh, milk. Didn't have any milk?
No, I was going to tell you, eggnog.
Oh, it's out.
I was surprised it's out so early.
Yeah.
But he said they had it.
Week.
Yeah. He had eggnog, and he got the lactose tolerant because Tessa has to drink that kind of milk. And they love eggnog. And he said, I didn't know how good it's going to be, but she loves it so good, the eggnog, I wanted to try it for her so it won't hurt her stomach. Well, he says, I want to tell you what, that is some good eggnog.
I got some.
And Tessa, she said, here, Tessa brought you some. She poured me some in a water bottle that they had washed out and everything. And he said, he wanted you to try it. So she had me a half a bottle. And I'm going to tell you what, to be lactose tolerant, which I never drink lactose tolerant stuff.
You've been saying that.
I ain't saying it right. I should have known I ain't saying it right. I knew I wasn't saying it right. I don't say words right. What's it called?
Probably lactose free or something like that.
Oh, yeah, because you're lactose tolerant.
You're not tolerant. That means if you're tolerant, that means you can take it. You're intolerant.
Oh, well, I ain't lactose saying things intolerant. Right. Well, anyway, it's lactose free.
We'll go with that. They know what you're talking about.
Anyway, he was surprised it was that good. He said, I might even start buying that kind all the time and drink it myself. And it was really, really good. I love eggnog.
Well, I got some when Mom was living. Around Christmas, and I've never really liked it, but the brand I bought right now, I can't think of the name of it. It was really good. I think you had some of it.
Yeah,
it was really
expensive. Anthony buys the same thing, I think.
It's more expensive, but it is good.
It's
can't
good.
Think of the name it's of good. It right now, y'all. All right, we're gonna run in here and get us a coffee. And what I was saying was, we're gonna go for lunch. I think. Here's what the plan was, and we're gonna go to Burger King because I had a coupon to get two Whopper Juniors and two fries. For $6.49.
That's cheap.
And then you have to buy whatever you're going to drink.
And I'm going to drink more.
I walked out and forgot it.
So now, are you changing your mind?
No.
Okay.
Not unless you want something else.
No, that's fine.
I love Burger King. I mean, I've always loved their hamburgers, but here... But I burped it. We got to go, y'all. This is not a good thing. But when I walked in... I normally don't come in and go through drive-thru, but when I walked in, I heard somebody say, we ain't got to slurp that thing.
Oh, Lord, I can't help but slurp. It's so good. You got to slurp.
No, you don't. Watch me.
And it's hot.
Mine's hot.
She don't slurp.
I know the majority of y'all probably slurp. Don't come for me. I can't stand it. I cannot stand it.
There's probably others out there that can't stand it.
I can't stand to hear slurping and smacking.
Smacking and slurping and all
but,
that sneaking.
You know, that's fine if you like it.
And Stephanie tried to tell me at work the other day, I need to hear, what is that, RSR or whatever that is when people do things.
ASMR.
And she said, Mama, you need to relax at night to go to sleep. You need to hear, say it again. You need to hear, listen to the...
ASMR.
And I said, ASMR. I said... You talking?
I like the kind without the talking. The talking freaks me out a little bit, but I like the sounds.
And I said, are you talking about all that? Like when I watch sometimes a channel that fixing lunches and all you hear is slap, 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 slap. I thought she would die laughing. She just thought that was the funniest to her. And she told Jamie all about it. I don't know why that was so funny.
You slurp that one more time. I'll take it from me. Anyway,
if I slurp this one more time, she's going to slap me.
I didn't say that. Then we talk about what I was going to say, and I don't remember.
No, she didn't say that.
I got the unusual, but what I was going to say was...
This is good.
This is not a good thing, I know. But when I went in with Tina, I never, hardly ever go in unless it's me and Tina. I don't go in by myself. I usually go through the drive-thru. And I walked in, and I heard, hey, Miss Annette. So I didn't know where it came from or who it came from. I said, hey, you know. There's three there that know me by my name, of course, because I come often. And, they'll say that every time. It just makes you feel so good, but I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing because I really go a lot. Anywho, so when I got there to order, she said, we're not getting the venti today. Well, first she had my order already queued up on the thing. Did you see that?
Yeah.
And I normally get a venti. And she said, we're going to get your usual. And I said, I think I'm going to take it down a notch. I'm going to go for a grande. I said, because we're going out for lunch. Mm-hmm. You know, I want to be hungry, whatever. Hot. So hot right now.
She's hot her whole
drinking
life.
Drinking this coffee.
Then she wants to drink coffee. Whew. You know them little Christmas tree cakes that you can buy right this time of the year? There she is hanging her head out the window. She's hot. Act like a dog. But anyway,
Annette,
when we got home yesterday, I have a little welcome sign standing at my, a little welcome sign standing at my front door, and she had two of them little Christmas cakes, little Debbie Christmas cakes.
Christmas tree cakes.
Yeah, up there, and it had Tessa's, to Tessa, love Ned.
Aunt Ned.
And to Brooklyn, love Aunt Ned on it. Them two girls walked right on in there and didn't even see it up there, and I walked
for
there.
Sure they would've
it's right at my eye level.
Yeah.
So I saw it, and I picked it up and went on with it. But I didn't get one. I thought about that. I thought she didn't get me.
I only had one left. And I know Earl likes them.
Only five
come in a pack, and I had eight.
I'm playing.
But what she's not telling you is I asked her, did she want one when I went over there?
I don't know. I was playing. Well, I just had to say that. But anyway, they ate them, and they liked them. Yeah, they were tickled over that. It makes them feel good, you know.
Well, how do y'all feel about them? Do y'all like them?
Yeah.
Now, I have not had one in years.
I seem like I did years ago, and
I didn't think I liked it either. But I'm gonna tell you what,
maybe they've improved.
Maybe they've done something else. Little sugar crystal things on there. They're good.
She's made me want to buy a box because I walked by it last Saturday at the grocery store, and I thought I don't like them. I ain't get them. I don't think I'm gonna try a box. Them girls like them, so that'd be good.
I like them, love them, want some more of them. Listen, tonight, which y'all are seeing this on Friday. So tonight, which is Thursday night, I have bowling, and of course today is Halloween, and we're going on my way to bowling. Tina's going to follow, but we're going to go up to where they're having a trunk or treat, and our friend Neil, you know, from the radio station, he is going to be there, and we told him we were going to come by and see him, so he's dressing up as Beetlejuice.
Yo, I got on radio yesterday that he was wanting people to try to guess who he was going to dress up as.
He was giving out little,
giving out hints.
Little hints.
And he said, and he, say it, don't say it three times.
When he said that, I was thinking I knew what he was going to be.
Well, I wasn't sure. I called him and I said, Beetlejuice.
Yeah.
He got all over himself.
He did.
But then he wasn't giving out no prizes. He
said, I wish I had a prize to give
you. Yeah, I said, that's all right.
Then he said he's going to be there tonight from 6 to 8. And Tina said, we might stop by, so we're going to try to stop by on my way to bowling.
And then I'll just come on back home, but I won't see him. I hope we get a picture with him is what I hope, dressed as big as you. Let somebody take us a picture or us do it. I can't wait to see him.
I know. Weekend, Saturday, tomorrow, so you're watching on Friday, so tomorrow, is Cotton Festival. We're going to the Cotton Festival, and they have got 190
Vendors. And some food trucks.
Food trucks and all those things. I wish so bad we could get a turkey leg. If they have them.
I know. They were $15 at, what was that at?
Cotton Festival.
Farmer's Day. They were $15 there and they say they were $20 at the state fair.
Mm-hmm. Well, we're going to bring y'all with us. Y'all want to go?
You want to go to
Let
the
us know in the comments down below if you want to go to Cotton Festival. Y'all know we went a few years ago. I'll try to pop it in a card up here on the right, I think, at the top, or either in screen or wherever. If y'all want to watch it when we went a few years ago, we put up a tent.
We had fun.
It was cold.
But it was cold, though. That's the only thing.
Cold.
Yeah.
Plus we were in the shade.
Yeah, if you had been in the sun, we'd probably been pretty much comfortable.
Yeah, because people were coming when they turned the corner. When they turned the corner, they came up under our tent because we were all in the shade. Mm-hmm. Oh, this feels so good. I said, we are about to freeze. She said, get out there in the sun. You'll be freezing.
I'd rather been in the sun.
And I think we got a funnel cake.
We did. Mm-hmm. We got one and shared it, I think.
Mm-hmm. So we won't do that. Saturday.
That'll be fun. I hope it's nice. I hope it ain't too cold.
I don't think it's supposed to.
Just nice.
I hope it don't rain. I don't think it is. But then after that, then that's Saturday, and then Sunday we have church, and we start revival.
Well, yeah, we do. Start revival.
How'd y'all like Tina's little get up yesterday on her little pumpkin? Everybody like your little hat?
I went to work with that little pumpkin on my head. And the thing of it is, and everybody just loved it. They thought it was so cute.
It's cute.
And the thing of it is, I forget I had it on too.
Did you hit it?
No, it's just I forget I have it on, and I'd walk out there not even thinking about it. I had that on my head. And there were some cops sitting at a table, and I walked over there to a table across from them, and because she kept looking at me smiling, and I started talking to her. She said, "I love your." Now, this is just to an elderly couple.
Oh, okay.
She said, "I love that little pumpkin on your head." I said, "Well, thank you." And then I started asking, "Did she need anything?" And they wanted more sweet tea. So I played waitress. I played waitress for a minute. And then across from them was about three cops sitting there, and they kept staring at me. And she said, "We have watched you every time you went that window. You are so cute with that."
I bet all they saw was that pumpkin.
We saw was that pumpkin. We didn't know whose head it was on. So, and now they just laughed. They just thought it was cute as a button, too. And I talked to them for a few minutes.
Tina's trying to win these donuts off the radio, y'all. And then we're going to run into
Ollie's
and Michael's. We said we were done, y'all.
Yeah, we did.
Look at Tina getting
I'm way up here because I'm short.
I don't have my tripod. I was letting your ear, won't it? Yeah. I don't have my tripod. But we said we wanted something sweet.
You want to see what it is? Indy's Frosty. You know, we got that so many coupons for a dollar.
Yeah, y'all remember the other day we bought a coupon book for a dollar, and you got how many Frosties? Four?
Five, I think.
Five free Frosties. Yeah. That's plenty for me.
It is for me, too.
I got chocolate.
But guess what I got? Pineapple.
Pineapple.
That's the new flavor out.
Ain't that cut cute?
I'm excited.
That's precious. Now we're fitting to make a mess is what we're fitting to do.
My straw.
We should took that outside. You can't. There's no hole.
Oh, I thought I saw a hole right there. Well.
No, there's not.
What are we going to do about it?
Well, we're going to be careful, Tina.
I got to sit back to be careful with mine.
We came out here, you know, to see Neil at the trunk of street. And, He looks like Beetlejuice, y'all.
He's acting the part with it, too. It is funny.
He is so funny.
Y'all, he's got a little bowl of candy, and then he's got a cooler down there of the good candy, what he calls all the good candy.
Like the chocolates and stuff. But, well, we're fixing to part ways, and I got to go bowling, but we had a fun day today.
We did.
I'd show y'all all over there, but there's a bunch of kids, and I don't want to do all that. But, And we tried to get a video of him, but there was children all around. But if I can crop some of them out or blur them out, I'll show you the little bit of what we had. But we do have some pictures, just us three.
Yeah. We had fun, though, today.
We did. We love you. We'll see you. We're going to Cotton Fest for Saturday, so we'll have some of that up next week.
All right. Bye. I hope you have a good day. Night.
Bye. Bye.